How do I disable the touchpad on my laptop? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Hey, if you're not subscribed to my newsletter, Confident Computing, head over to askleo.com/newsletter and sign up today. Every week I share tips, tricks, and answers like this one. So, one of the things that is interesting about touchpads is the technology behind them, right? You just touch it, your mouse moves and you click and all that kind of stuff. It's a very useful interface for a lot of people. However, it's also the cause of sometimes unexplained behavior. For example, you may be typing and all of a sudden your mouse may move, and sometimes it's because you may be accidentally touched the touchpad, or the touchpad is overly sensitive, or any number of things that can be related to the touchpad that can interfere with what it is you're doing. One of the things many people like to do is turn it off. So I'm going to show you how to do that in Windows 10 and 11, and then we'll talk a little bit about some of the other options you may have in case you're running an older system or what I'm about to show you doesn't work or isn't present. The traditional solution, the traditional way to get to this settings, is to click on the Start button and then start typing touchpad. And sure enough, there's an item called touchpad settings. But in my case at least, it's bringing up the mouse settings, and touchpad settings are nowhere to be seen. It is possible that this may lead you to believe you don't have touchpad settings. You probably do. What I'm going to do instead here is in the search box for the settings app, I'm going to search for touchpad again. This time, I'm going to click on touchpad settings. And lo and behold, a completely different set of settings, the exact settings that we're looking for. You want to turn the touchpad off? Great. Click on the on to turn it off. And you no longer have a touchpad. It's present, but it's been turned off. That's the simple solution. And like I said, that works for both Windows 10 and 11. Those settings should be there. If not, if for some reason you don't find them, and excuse me while I turn my touchpad back on because I want to use it when that time comes. There are other possible places to look for these kinds of settings. Now, before you get this serious, turning off the touchpad, what I'd like you to look for are related settings. You'll note that in that settings screen, there were a bunch of other settings related to the touchpad. None of them applied for what I'm about to describe. But that's a function of the driver for that specific touchpad. Some drivers actually allow you to control the sensitivity. And if you see that there is a sensitivity settings in your touchpad settings, I'm going to encourage you to play with that first, because that may resolve the issue of accidental taps or accidental mouse movement, even without turning off the touchpad completely. That way, you can still use it if you want to. You don't have to turn it off. However, those settings, like I said, are driver specific. They may appear in the Windows settings user interface, but if they're not there, then you may not have that option, and turning it off might be the right thing to do. Now, I've used Windows 11 and Windows 10 as my example here, and what I've shown you should work for those. In the past, or if those settings don't appear, what I'm going to suggest you do also is look in Control Panel. In older versions of Windows, it's fairly straightforward. In the current version of Windows, to actually find the old Control Panel, you can in fact search for Control Panel and it shows up just more or less the way you might remember it. I'm going to view by small icons because that's the layout that I prefer. And yes, here in mouse is where you'll end up wanting to look for settings related to the hardware that you have. A touchpad may appear here. Again, this is driver specific. This is the kind of stuff that is going to change from machine to machine depending on the specific driver that you may have installed for your specific touchpad. If nothing shows up here, In other words, there's no option to deal with the touchpad or turn it off or adjust its settings. The next thing I'm going to have you do is take a look at Device Manager. I've right-clicked on the Start button and I'll click on Device Manager. And you can see here that there are a number of devices that are listed. Mice and other pointing devices is the interesting one. Now, here's the problem. Your touchpad may be listed here, but it may not be called a touchpad. A touchpad is often designed to mimic a mouse, because basically you do the same thing with your touchpad as you do with a mouse. You move the mouse pointer around and you click and double click. You may have some gestures, but the bottom line is that fundamentally a touchpad is mimicking a mouse. What that means is that here in Device Manager, one of these two things that is called a mouse might very well be my touchpad. I don't know which one, and I don't know what's going to happen if I turn it off. Turning it off, by the way, I would simply say disable the device. That way you're not uninstalling anything, and if you then want to re-enable it, you can. Here's the problem, though. If you happen to accidentally disable your mouse, you can no longer use your mouse to turn it back on. That's when I suggest you first become familiar with the keyboard interface to this program. And that typically boils down to using your up and down arrow keys and your right and left arrow keys to expand things, the enter key to bring it up, the tab key to tab between different controls. Here again is the driver. Here's the disable the device. Again, that would be enable the device if you want to. So that's what I would suggest you do before you do anything in the Device Manager. You make sure to understand how to undo it using the keyboard interface in case you happen to disable the mouse. Now, the last thing that is kind of the last straw to grasp at, and that is your UEFI/BIOS. Very often, you will find a setting in the BIOS for your specific machine that will allow you to enable or disable the built-in touchpad. I can't tell you how to get there because that varies from machine to machine. It involves rebooting and usually typing a special character so that instead of booting into Windows, it boots into the BIOS or UEFI settings. You'll have to contact your manufacturer for that. However, once you're in there, look for the setting. See if there's an option to turn off the touchpad at the BIOS level so that Windows never even thinks you have one. And of course, the very, very last straw to grasp at is if none of this works, if you can't find any settings related to your touchpad, reach out to your computer's manufacturer. They may have advice on what to do. They may have updated drivers that expose more functionality. They are your last source for help. If they can't help you, you may not be able to turn off your touchpad. In which case, honestly, I have seen people tape things over the touchpad to make sure that it's never touched. Hope that helps. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/2449. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.